Myself, Professor Sangeeta Gehlot from Department of Kriya Sharir, Faculty of Ayurveda, IMS, BHU. In this lecture, we will discuss about understanding of physiology of Vasa, Medh and Majja. Ayurveda scholars have mentioned different tissues like Vasa, that is intramuscular fat, Medh, that is visceral fat, and Majja, bone marrow, which are predominantly rich in adipocytes similar to adipose tissues with the different sites, functions, compositions and pathological outcomes. Adipose tissue is basically a loose connective tissue comprised of mainly adipocytes including nerve tissue, stromovascular cells and immune cells which are present in different places of body. A comprehensive description of therapeutic indications of Vasa and Majja under Snehan Karm, that is oleation therapy, illustrates that clinical physiology of these tissues has been elaborated rather than general physiology. In texts of Ayurveda, description is available regarding distribution of Medh in different places of the body with different names like in small bones and abdomen, that is around viscera, called as Medh, that is visceral fat. In long bones is known as Majja, while intermuscular fat is termed as Vasa, that is muscle fat. And their role in maintenance of physiology and manifestation of diseases have been also mentioned. Metabolic effect of Medh and Majja Dhatu on other tissues like muscle, bone and reproductive tissues has been mentioned, showing their functional interdependence. This lecture is an attempt to understand the physiological aspect of Vasa, Medh and Majja altogether based on the therapeutic indication for the management of diversity of disorders in the form of Sneha through different therapeutic measures and differentiation of Vasa, Medh, Majja based on the functional peculiarities of adipocytes present in different sites of body like omentum, muscle and bone marrow. The word Medhas is derived from Snehaarthak Trimidha Snehan Dhatu. Amar Koshkar has mentioned Medh as Medhyati Snehati Iti Medha, meaning oleation or to apply oil. Medho Dhatu is the unctuous dhatu like Ghrit. Majjati Asthishu Iti Majja, which is present inside the bone, is known as Majja. Medhas Sthani Puryante Sneho Majja Tathah Smrateh. Charak has mentioned that the Vayu produces hollowness in inner portions of bone which is filled with Medh, and that unctuous substance is known as Majja. Vasa Mans Sneha. While commenting on Charak Sharir 7th verse 15, Chakrapani has mentioned Vasa as Mans Sneha. Vasa Mans Niryase Mastulung Ardhvilin Gratakaro Mastak Majja. Dhalan on commenting on Sushrut Sutra 23rd chapter verse 12 considered Vasa as Mans Niryas and Mastak Majja has been mentioned as Mastulung Ardhvilin Gritakara. Sites of Vasa, Medh and Majja. Tritya Medodhara Medohi Sarvabhuta Nam Udarast Anu Asthishu Che Mahatam Su Cha Majja Bhavati. In description of Kala, Acharya Sushrut has considered that third Kala is Medodhara Kala, which can be considered omentum and deep fascia as per contemporary science. In all human beings, Medh is present in abdomen and small bones, while Majja is present in large bones. Sarakt Medh is present in small bones. During the manifestation of obesity, excess deposition of Medh Dhatu occurs around the buttocks, abdomen and breast. Shuddha Mansasya Yeh Isneha Sa Vasa Parikirtita. Sushrut has mentioned that Vasa is the unctuous part of Shuddha Mans or may be considered as fat content of flesh. Normally, abdomen is considered as the collecting site of Vasa. During obesity, this collection or aggregation further increases, but this collection also increases in other parts too. But abdomen is the particular site. In the body, this deposition takes place mostly below the skin in subcutaneous tissues. Besides it, it is also deposited in omentum, which is known as vapavahan. Vapa means carrying of Vasa. Charak has considered vapavahan among 15 koshtang, Chakrapani has mentioned Vapa Vahanam Medhasthanam Tel Vartika, means considered Vapa Vahan as the site of Med. For bodily sneha in Ayurveda, Majja Vasa Med and Sarakt Med, these four words have been used. Majja is present in large bones and is of yellow color, hence known as yellow marrow. Vasa has been considered as unctuous part of Shuddha Mans. Vasa is Ubdhatu. Both Med and Vasa chemically comes under fat. After 5 years of age, all large bones starts becoming fatty, and after 20 years of age becomes fatty, and due to which they are not helpful in RBC formation. Considering this quality, Ayurvedic scholars have not described Majja as blood forming organs, that is liver and spleen, and considered Majja under Dhatu due to Dharan and Poshan function. Types of Med and Majja Dhatu. While describing the Dushya of Prameh, Charak has mentioned that Med is of two types, Badh and Abadh. Badh Med can be considered as visceral adipocytes, as they are situated in udar and small bones, while Abadh Med can be considered as circulating lipids. Majja Dhatu has been also classified as Asthigat Majja and Mastakgat Majja, Rakt Majja and Pit Majja. Composition of yellow and red bone marrow. If we see the cellular composition, in yellow bone marrow, 95% are fat cells and 5% are non-fat cells. And in red bone marrow, 40% fat cells and 60% hematopoietic cells are present. In chemical composition, in yellow bone marrow, 80% fat cells, 15% water and 5% protein is present. In red bone marrow, 40% fat, 40% water and 20% protein is. Anatomical distribution of Vasa, Med and Majja. Vasa is unctuousness of well-nourished Mansha Dhatu, and in contemporary description it may be considered as subcutaneous white adipose tissues. Its site is buttocks, thighs and abdomen. Site of Med is cavity of small bones in abdomen, and in contemporary science it may be considered as visceral white adipose tissue. Site is around the omentum, intestines and perirenal areas. Med is in contemporary science also considered as brown adipose tissues. Its site is cervical, axillary, interscapular and supraclavicular region. Vasa accounting for 85% of total adipocytes of body, Med account for 10% of total adipocytes of the body. Majja is present in cavities of long bones as Majja Dhatu, and in skull bones are termed as skull bone marrow, that is Mastulung or Mastakgat Majja. In contemporary description, it may be considered as bone marrow adipose tissue. It is present in ribs, sternum, vertebrae and medullary canal of long bones. Rakt Majja is present in long bones. In contemporary description, it may be considered as red bone marrow, regulated marrow adipose tissues. It is present in interspersed within active hematopoietic sites such as mid to proximal tibia, femur and lumbar vertebra. Pit Majja may be considered as yellow bone marrow or constitutive marrow adipose tissue. It is present in distal tibia and caudal vertebra of the tail. Panchbhautik composition and quantity. Medo jal prithviyatmakam majja cha apyam. Chakrapani, commenting on Sushruta Sutra 15.8, has considered Med is composed of Jal and Prithvi Mahabhut, while Majja is composed of Jal Mahabhut. Jal Mahabhut imparts features like Mriduta, Snigdhata. Prithvi Mahabhut provides Guruta and Snigdhata. Trayavasaya Dva Medhase Eko Majjaya Mastikaske Ardhanjali. Charak in Shariristhan has mentioned the measurement of Vasaya is 3 Anjali, Medhas is 2 Anjali, while Majja is 1 Anjali and Mastishk Majja is Ardhanjali. This dissimilar proportion is similar to that of different proportion of subcutaneous white adipose tissue, brown adipose tissue, visceral adipose tissue and MAT. Sweat is 85% of total adipose tissue, visceral white adipose tissue is 10% and brown adipose tissue is less than the fat. उपधातु एंड मल ऑफ मेद एंड मज्जा धातु. उपधातु ऑफ मेद इज स्नायु दैट इज टेंडन वाइल मल इज स्वेद. कंसिडरेशन ऑफ स्वेद एज मल माइट बी इंडिकेटिंग थर्मोरेगुलेशन ऑफ एडिपोसाइट्स. प्रोफ्यूज परस्पिरेशन इज ऑब्जर्व इन ओबेस इंडिविजुअल्स विच डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट दैट मोर द अमाउंट ऑफ मेद मोर विल बी फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्वेद. स्वेट मेंटेन्स द मॉइस्टनेस एंड सॉफ्टनेस ऑफ स्किन. रेसिप्रोकल रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन स्वेट एंड यूरिन मीन्स इंक्रीज स्वेटिंग लीड्स टू डिक्रीज यूरिन फॉर्मेशन. मल ऑफ मज्जा धातु इज स्नेह ऑफ आइज फिसेस एंड स्किन. सीबम मे बी कंसिडर्ड एज अंक्टुअसनेस ऑफ स्किन. सीबम इज एन ऑयली सिक्रीशन ऑफ सीबेशियस ग्लैंड्स. मिक्सचर ऑफ ट्राइग्लिसराइड कोलेस्ट्रॉल प्रोटीन एंड इनऑर्गेनिक सॉल्ट. इट प्रिवेंट्स एक्सेसिव इवेपोरेशन ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम द स्किन एंड इनहिबिट्स द ग्रोथ ऑफ सर्टेन बैक्टीरिया. इट कोट्स द सर्फेस ऑफ हेयर्स एंड प्रिवेंट्स ड्राइनेस एंड ब्रिटिलनेस ऑफ द हेयर. फिजियोनाटोमिकल डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ वसा मेद एंड मज्जा. मेद एंड मज्जा इज धातु वाइल वसा इज उपधातु ऑफ मांस. मेद इज जल मेड अप ऑफ जल एंड पृथ्वी महाभूत. मज्जा इज मेड अप ऑफ जल महाभूत. मेद इज प्रेजेंट इन कैविटी ऑफ स्मॉल बोन्स एंड एबडोमन रेड बोन मैरो. मज्जा इज प्रेजेंट इन कैविटीज ऑफ लॉन्ग बोन्स एंड स्कल बोन्स. वसा इज प्रेजेंट इन स्नेह और अंक्टुअसनेस ऑफ मसल. मेद इज ऑफ टू टाइप बद्ध एंड अबद्ध. मज्जा इज ऑफ अगेन रेड एंड येलो बोन मैरो अस्थिगत एंड मस्तूलों. क्वांटिटी ऑफ मेद इज 2 अंजलि. क्वांटिटी ऑफ मज्जा इज 1 अंजलि. मस्तूलोंगत मज्जा क्वांटिटी इज अर्धांजलि. वसा मेजरमेंट इज 3 अंजलि. मेद प्रोवाइड्स अंक्टुअसनेस स्वेट स्टेबिलिटी एंड नरिशमेंट ऑफ बोन्स वाइल मज्जा प्रोवाइड्स अंक्टुअसनेस स्ट्रेंथ नरिशमेंट ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन एंड फिलिंग ऑफ बोन. नरिशमेंट ऑफ मेद एंड मज्जा धातु. मांसम मांसान मेद देह प्रजायते मेदसो अस्थि ततो मज्जा. डलन ऑन कमेंटिंग सोशल सूत्र 14 वर्स 10 मेंशन तेषां रसादीनां मल स्थूलाणु अभाग विशेषेण त्रिविध परिणामो भवति. श्रोत्र नासा कर्णाक्षी प्रजननादि स्रोतो मल है स्थूल भागो मांसम सूक्ष्मो मेद है. ततो अपि निज वहीनी पच्यमान अनल है स्वेद है स्थूलो अंशो मेद एव सूक्ष्म भागो अस्थि. धातु आर नरिश्ड बाई आहार रस एंड देयर नरिशमेंट इज अफेक्टेड बाई बोथ क्वालिटेटिव एंड क्वान्टिटेटिव स्टेटस ऑफ रस धातु एंड प्रीवियस धातु. मेद धातु एंड वसा गेट नरिश्ड बाई मांस धातु वाइल मज्जा बाई अस्थि धातु. नॉर्मल फंक्शनल स्टेट ऑफ मांस एंड मांस धातुवाग्नि नरिशेज मेद धातु अप्रोप्रिएटली बट ऑन विशिएशन इट डिस्टर्ब्स द नरिशमेंट ऑफ मेद धातु. सिमिलरली नरिशमेंट ऑफ मज्जा गेट्स अफेक्टेड बाई अस्थि धातु. प्रीवियस स्टडीज हैव रिपोर्टेड दैट बोन मैरो एडिपोसाइट्स एंड ऑस्टियोब्लास्ट शेयर्स कॉमन प्रिकर्सर एंड अफेक्ट्स जेनेसिस ऑफ ईच अदर. इट्स नरिशमेंट माइट बी ऑल्सो अफेक्टेड बाई मेद धातु टू. एक्शन ऑफ मेदोधातवाग्नि ऑन पोष्य पोर्शन ऑफ मेद धातु रिजल्ट्स इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ मेद धातु एंड स्वेद एज मल अस्थि फ्रॉम द माइन्यूट फ्रैक्शन अंडर मेद धातुवाग्नि. ऑल द हार्मोन्स अफेक्टिंग फैट मेटाबॉलिज्म लाइक इंसुलिन कॉर्टिसोल ACTH as well as adipokines released from the adipocytes can be included. Action of majja dhatvagni over the poshya portion of majja dhatu results in the formation of majja dhatu, unctuousness in eyes, faces and skin as mal and formation of shukra dhatu. Medvah and majja vah srotas. Medovah dve tayor mulam kativ rakkau che. Medovah nam srotsam rakkau mulam पपावहनम च. मज्जावाहनम स्रोतसाम अस्थिनी मूलम संदेहश्च. द रूट्स ऑफ मेदोवह स्रोतस आर कटी वृक एंड वपावहन एंड मांस वाइल ऑफ मज्जावह स्रोतस आर अस्थि एंड संधि. वपावहन इज ए अंक्टुअस वर्तिका सिचुएटेड इन एबडोमन एंड नोन एज तेल वर्तिका. वर्तिका इज ए विक एंड इन एबडोमिनल कैविटी एनी स्ट्रक्चर Simulating unctuous wick is not seen. Presently, vapa is considered as omentum, which is a spreaded structure, not like a wick. However, the word vartik is replaced by vartin, means resting situated and omentum. An unctuous structure situated or resting in abdomen can be accepted. The sotromool are the primary sites of onset of pathogenesis or the organ through which disease signs and symptoms of a particular srotas get manifested. These organs too have an important role in pathophysiological conditions related to adipose tissue. Medha has also been considered as mool of asthivya srotas, while majja as mool of shukravya srotas. Recently, it has been found that osteoclastin secreted by bone affects fat metabolism and insulin sensitivity, thus affecting the functions of adipose tissue. There are certain probable reasons. Consideration of kidney, mans and vapa vahan and kati as a mool of medhovah srotas. Regarding kidney, adiporenal axis is established by various autocrine and endocrine secretions, that is adiponectins and pro-inflammatory factors released by adipocytes, which affects the normal functioning of the kidney as well as its response to injury and inflammatory factors. Again, chronic kidney diseases are linked with obesity and is one of the risk factors to aggravate primary renal disease. Hyperlipidemia is present in some kidney disorders like nephritic syndrome. Regarding mans as a mool of medhovah srotas, certain studies have reported that myokines released by contracting muscles form a crosstalk between skeletal muscle and adipose tissue. These myokines, besides affecting the functioning of skeletal muscle, also affect adipose tissue. Vapa vahan and kati as a mool of medhovah srotas, that is omental fat and waste. Main sites for the deposition of visceral fat is vapa vahan and kati. In the case of obesity, the adipocytes present in omentum release adiponectin, which is responsible for chronic subinflammatory reactions in the body leading to metabolic disorders. As per Ayurveda description also, main sites of deposition of fat in obesity are buttocks, abdomen and breast. Since kati as a mool of medhovah srotas has clinical significance and influential in deciding the grade of obesity, hip waist ratio is considered as one of the best determinants of the obesity. Causes of vitiation of medh and majjhavah srotas. Avyayamadi diva swapnan medhya nam chati bhakshanat medo vahini dushyanti varunecha adi sevanat. Avyayamadi means lack of physical exercise. Diva swapn, day sleeping. Medhya nam chati bhakshanat, excessive intake of fatty meals. Varunyash ati sevanat, over drinking of varuni. These are the causes of vitiation of medhovah srotas. While majjhavah srotas are vitiated due to utpeshadya ati abhishandad abhighatat prabidnat majjhavahini dushyanti vruddhanam cha sevanat. Means majjhavah srotas are vitiated due to crushing injury, overuse of abhishandi substance, that is channel blocking food, trauma, compression and use of food substances with contrary properties. Features of vitiation of medhovah srotas: sweating, unctuousness in the injured area, dryness of palate, obesity, inflammation, thirst, prodromal symptoms of prameh. These are the features of vitiation of medhovah srotas. Features of vitiation of majjhavah srotas: रुक प्रवणाम भ्रमो मूर्छा दर्शनम तमस तथा अरुषाम स्थूल मूलानाम पर्वजानाम च दर्शनम. रुक प्रवणाम अर्थ्रेलजिया, भ्रमो गिडीनेस, मूर्छा फेंटिंग, दर्शनम तमस तथा अपीयरेंस ऑफ डार्कनेस बिफोर द आईज. अरुषाम स्थूल मूलानाम, appearance of deep or wide rooted ulcers over the joint. These are the features of fixation of Majja Dhatu. Arunshiti Vrananam. Arunsha refers to ulcers or wound. Sthul Moolam is explained as Gambhir Parinahanam, means deep expanse or penetration. Functions of Medh Dhatu. Medh Dhatu provides unctuousness to whole body. Sweating provides stability and provides nourishment to bone. Functions of Majja Dhatu. Majja Dhatu provides unctuousness and strength to whole body. Nourishment to Shukra Dhatu fills the cavity of bones. Medh and Majja Dhatu have been opined to play an important role in nourishment of bone and reproductive tissues. Their imbalance in a state of physiology, that is Medh Vriddhi and Majja Kshay, affects functioning of bone tissue and produces abnormalities. These functions might be indicative of the role of adiponectin and leptin secreted by adipocytes in bone remodeling and reproductive functions. In short-term conditions, bone growth is inhibited due to increased apoptosis and decreased proliferation, while in long-term regulation, bone formation is increased by the adiponectin. In the recent past, adipocytes were understood as an energy depots only, but now adipocytes secretes a group of adipokines like leptin, adiponectin, etc., which had a wide range of physiological role, including food intake, energy homeostasis, inflammation, glucose homeostasis, lipid metabolism, and angiogenesis. Interdependence of Vasa, Medh and Majja. Functionally, they are interdependent to each other. Recent researches have reported that various chemicals secreted by adipocytes present at different sites of the body help in functional regulation of tissue like bone, muscles and reproductive tissues, as described in Ayurveda. However, in Ayurveda, regulation of reproductive tissue has been explained as function of Majja Dhatu. Recent studies have reported evidence of induced spermatogenesis from bone marrow adipocytes in angiospermic hamsters. Features of Medh Kshay. Plihabhi Vriddhi, Sandhi Shunyata, Rakshyam, Medur Mans Prarthana Che, Medhasi Shine, Katya Swapah, Plihe Vriddhi Krashangata Che. Plihabhi Vriddhi, Splenomegaly. Chakrapani has considered Plihabhi Vriddhi, that is splenomegaly, due to displacement. This can be due to emaciation of fat surrounding the spleen, or it can be palpable due to emaciated body. Sandhi Shunyata, hollowness or lightness in joints due to diminished fat cells in surrounding bones. Rakshyam, emaciation of the body or roughness in the body. Medur Mans Prarthana Che, desirous of eating mans of medasvi animals. This desire may be based on the principle of Samanyam Vriddhi Karanam to compensate the deficiency of Medh. Katya Swapah, as Kati is the site of Medh, due to Medh Kshay, feeling of numbness or loss of sensation over the Kati. Krishangatva, these are the features of Medh Kshay. Features of Medh Vriddhi. Cardiorespiratory disturbances, exertional dyspnea, enlargement of abdomen, buttocks, breast and flanks due to excess deposition of fat in these areas. These are the features similar to that of obesity. Features of Majja Kshay. Majja Kshay Alpa Shukrita, Parv Bhedo, Asthi Nistod, Asthi Shunyata Che, Asthanam Majjani Swashiryam, Brahm Timir Darshanam. Majja Kshay results in diminished Shukra. Parv Bhedo, Asthi Nistod, pain in bones and joints, and Asthi Shunyata, emptiness in bones. Swashiryam, porosity of the bones. Brahm, vertigo. Timir Darshanam, darkness in front of the eyes. These are the features of Majja Kshay. Besides these features, Charak has mentioned Pratatam Vata Rogini may be justified as blood cell precursors are present in bone marrow and due to decrease in Majja will cause decrease in blood which may lead to Vata Prakop. Further, due to Majja Chay, filling of Asthi with Majja will decrease and as Asthi is the site of Vata will cause Vata Prakop as decrease of Asthi will cause increase in Vata. Features of Majja Vriddhi. Majja Sarvang Netra Gaurvam Chay. Majja Netrang Gaurvam Parvasu Sthul Mulani Kuryat Krishna Arunishi Chay. Heaviness in whole body and eyes. Deep-seated eruptions in joints. In Ashtang Sangraha, Rakt Gaurav has been mentioned as feature of Majja Vriddhi, which indicates the increased viscosity of blood in conditions of hyperproliferative bone marrow in like in polycythemia. Features of Medha Sarpurush. Individual having Medhas as constitutional essence has unctuousness of complexion, voice, eyes, hair, body, hair, nails, teeth, lips, urine and faces, well-developed body, intolerance to exertion, endowed with richness, happiness, enjoyment, luxury, simplicity, sukumarta, tenderness in dealing with the others. Features of Majja Sarpurush. Individuals having Majja as constitutional essence have soft organs, are strong, have unctuous complexion, voice, thick, long and rounded joints. They have good longevity, are strong and endowed with learning, wealth, critical understanding, progeny and respect. A study by Bradla M.A. et al. Suggested that visceral adipose tissues are positively associated with bone marrow adipocytes, but while describing the therapeutic properties of Majja, it is mentioned that Majja increases Medha Dhatu also. These explanations suggest the plasticity between bone marrow and visceral adipocyte. Different therapeutic indications of Vasa and Majja in Snehan. Vasa and Majja have been described under Snehdravya, but they have different therapeutic indications. Snehpan has been also advised as per dosh and circadian rhythm. Intake of Majja and Vasa has been advised during aspirin. Sneh should be taken during night in conditions of Vatpit excess and summer, while during the midday in excess of Kaph dosh and winter. Selection of a specific type of Snehdravya, that is Vasa and Majja, as per season and dosh might be indicating circadian rhythm in fat metabolism. Recent studies have also proven that enzymes involved in fat metabolism behave differently as per circadian rhythm. Diurnal variations in metabolites of fatty acids, steroid hormones, as well as acyl carnitine, glycerophospholipids and sphingolipids have been also reported. Recent studies on adipose tissue also reported that adipocytes present in different parts of the body have peculiarities in terms of functions and response to environmental cues. Properties of Vasa Majja. Majja and Vasa are sweet, bhringan, aphrodisiac and promoter of strength. Their hotness and coldness is to be determined as per nature of source, means animal from which fat or marrow is procured. Yatha Sattva, that is as per nature, insinuates the nature of animal. Like animals of marshy places are hot, thus their fat and marrow will also be hot. Animals of arid zone are cold, their fat and marrow is also cold. Contemporary research have also reported that on exposure to cold, there is increased browning of white adipose tissue as well as recruitment of brown adipose tissue at their sites, which results in enhanced thermogenesis and mitochondrial activity. Indication of Vasa. Vasa is indicated in those who have tolerance to wind and heat, having rough body, are emaciated due to weight carrying and travelling on foot, have deficient semen and blood, cough and fat absorbed, suffering from intense pain of bone joints, veins, tendons, vital parts and abdomen, have a strong vata covering all channels, whose digestive power is very strong. Vasa is also indicated in wounds caused by puncture or perforation, fracture, trauma, यूट्रो वेजाइनल डिस्प्लेसमेंट, ईयर रैक एंड हेड एक. यूजफुल फॉर इंक्रीजिंग विरिलिटी एंड सीमेन, वैल्यूबल फॉर अंक्शन एंड दोज हु इन्वॉल्व इन फिजिकल एक्सरसाइज. इंडिकेशन ऑफ मज्जा, पर्सन्स हैविंग स्ट्रॉन्ग डाइजेस्टिव पावर, एबिलिटी टू बियर स्ट्रेस, रेगुलर इनटेक ऑफ स्नेक, डिसऑर्डर्स ड्यू टू वात दोष, दोज हु आर हैविंग क्रूर कोस्ट. इट एनहेंसेज कफ, रस धातु, मेद धातु, मज्जा, शुक्र एंड स्ट्रेंथ. इट इंक्रीजेज द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ बोन स्पेशली. फैट एंड मैरो शुड बी टेकन ड्यूरिंग स्प्रिंग. वन शुड नॉट टेक एनी ओलियजिनस सब्सटेंसेज ड्यूरिंग एक्सट्रीम हॉट एंड कोल्ड. इफेक्ट ऑफ एडिपोकाइंस रिलीज बाई एडिपोसाइट्स इन फंक्शनिंग ऑफ अदर टिश्यूज. इन रक्त धातु इट परफॉर्म्स हिमोपैटिक फंक्शन एंड मेंटेन्स इम्यूनिटी. इन मांस धातु मायोकाइंस रिलीज बाई कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग मसल्स रेगुलेट ग्लूकोज एंड लिपिड मेटाबॉलिज्म. इन अस्थि धातु रेगुलेट्स ऑस्टियोब्लास्टोजेनेसिस एंड ऑस्टियोक्लास्टोजेनेसिस. कोलेस्ट्रॉल हेल्प्स इन सिंथेसिस ऑफ विटामिन डी. इन शुक्र धातु लेप्टिन रेगुलेट्स सिग्नलिंग टू हाइपोथैलेमिक पिट्यूटरी एड्रिनल ओवेरियन एक्सिस एंड हेल्प्स इन रिप्रोडक्टिव मैच्यूरेशन. बेस्ड ऑन दिस डिस्क्रिप्शन वी मे कंक्लूड दैट आयुर्वेद स्कॉलर्स हैड डीप इनसाइट्स रिगार्डिंग न्यूट्रिशन एंड मेटाबॉलिज्म ऑफ मेद एंड मज्जा एज दे हैव डिस्क्राइब्ड अबाउट देयर कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स, फंक्शंस, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, क्वान्टिटी एंड सेपरेट विशिएटिंग फैक्टर्स. डिफरेंट थेरेप्यूटिक इंडिकेशंस अंडर स्नेपान ऑप्टेन फ्रॉम एनिमल सोर्सेज एज पर सर्केडियन रेथ सीजन्स एंड डिसऑर्डर्स. ऑल दीज डिस्क्रिप्शन आर कंसिस्टेंट विद द रिसेंट एडवांसमेंट इन फिजियोलॉजी एंड बायोमोलिकुलर स्टडीज ऑफ एडिपोसाइट्स प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट साइट्स ऑफ द बॉडी. द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फंक्शनल एंड न्यूट्रिशनल इंटरडिपेंडेंस ऑफ धातु हैज बीन डिस्क्राइब्ड बाई आयुर्वेदिक स्कॉलर्स. मज्जा धातु ऑन अदर टिश्यूज लाइक ए मसल, bone and reproductive tissues show their functional interdependence, which is consistent with the recent research finding of contemporary science. Entire discussion clarified that Ayurveda scholar had a profound understanding about the clinical physiology of med and majja dhatu. Thanks to all.